Hello students, welcome to Narayan PU College online classes. And the previous video we have discussed about the classification and still some part is there. And first one we have discussed classification based upon the number of halogen atoms, and the second one is classification based upon hybridization. In that one, first concept we have completed, and that is compounds containing the sp3cx bond. And the second one is here, compound containing sp2cx bond. And these type of compounds further divided into two types. One is vinylic halides and aryl halides. So vinylic halides means, previous we have discussed the vinyl group CH3, CH2 double bond and CH. And this group we will call as a vinyl group. And if halogen atom is attached to this vinyl group, and that compound we will call as a vinylic halides. Because this is a vinyl group. This is a which group here? Vinyl group. So that's why. And this halide we will call as a vinylic halide. Means in vinylic halide, the halogen atom is directly attached to the sp2 hybridized carbon. Clear? And another one example. Another one is, you can take this is also cyclohexene. See, this, if halogen is attached here, this is also which group? Vinylic group. And here you see, double bonded carbons are there. So vinylic group this is. So that's why to this vinyl, halogen atom is attached. So that's why we will call it is a vinylic halides. And next one, aryl halides. We have already discussed aryl halides and haloarenes. In that one, halogen atom is directly attached to the benzene ring, or you can say this is halogen atom is directly attached to the benzene ring, and this type of compounds we will call as a aryl halides. Yeah, so these are the sp2cx bond containing compounds. Yeah, and the next one we will discuss about nomenclature of haloalkanes and haloarenes. And first we will discuss nomenclature of haloalkanes, and after that we will go for nomenclature of haloarenes. First one is here, haloalkanes. Haloalkanes can also be called as alkyl halides. Clear? Alkyl halides. These are, you know, the first one, IUPAC name and common name, both we will discuss. IUPAC name. This is the IUPAC name. Haloalkane is the IUPAC name. Haloalkane. This is the IUPAC name. And what is the common name for these compounds? That is, previous we have already discussed. These compounds can also be called as a alkyl halides. Means, common name is alkyl halides. Common name is what it is? Alkyl halides. Yeah. And the examples are there, and when you discuss about the example, you will get the clarity. But before going to discuss about the examples, here we need to discuss some important common names of important groups. So what are those groups are here? And CH3. A common name of some important groups, because these are very, very important throughout this organic chemistry we will use. And this, two CH3 groups are attached to the CH, and this group we will call as iso. That group we will call as which one? Iso. Clear? So now, here how many carbon atoms are there? 1, 2, 3. 3 carbon atoms, what we will call it? Propyl. So that's why, because common name means what it is? Halides, alkyl halides. So that's why isopropyl. What is this group here? This group we will call what it is? Iso. The group we will call iso. How many carbons are there? 3. So that's why propyl, isopropyl. Suppose to this halogen atom is there, we will call the isopropyl halide. Got the point? Now, suppose same I will write here another one compound, and that is CH3. And CH, CH3 and CH2. This is the group. See, now this group we will call as a, what we will call? Iso. Clear? CH3, CH3, CH group. This we will call as a iso. But how many carbons are there in this compound? 4. So that's why we will write this one as isobutyl. If halogen atom is attached here, then isobutyl halide. Clear? In the same way, another group is there, and CCH3, CH3, and CH3. This group. This we will call as a tertiary. This we will call as a which one? Tertiary. Now you see here. In this one, this is a tertiary group. But how many carbon atoms are there? 4. So tertiary butyl. This we will call as tertiary butyl. If suppose X is here, tertiary butyl halide. Yeah. But this group we will call as a tertiary. In the same way, and here another group is present. That is CH2. This is. And this group we will call, see, and up to here it is a tertiary, but here this group, one CH2 if add, this group we will call as neo. This group we will call as what it is here. So that tertiary one CH2 group is added, that we will call as a neo. How many carbons are there? 5. So that's why we will call it is a neopentyl. This we will call as neopentyl. Suppose another one compound, same another CH2 suppose added. CH3 and here CH3, CH3, CH2, CH2. What we will call this group? And you know this group we will call as a neo. This is, we will write neo. But how many carbons are there? 6 carbons. So that's why neohexyl. That is. Yeah? So these are very important groups. We must know the common names of these groups, because frequently we will use this neo, tertiary, iso in the organic chemistry. Okay? And another very important common name of some compounds, that is, if suppose two halogen atoms are attached to the same carbon atom. Two halogen atoms are attached to the same carbon atom. This is R, you can write CH3X, and here what it is? CH3. See, here two halogen atoms are attached to the same carbon. For this, common name is, the common name of these compounds are geminal dihalides. Geminal dihalides. What is the common name of this compound? Geminal dihalides. Or simply you can write here, gem dihalide, short form. Gem dihalides. Are also another name is there, that is alkylidene halides. These are the compounds. IUPACNM easily we will write, we will discuss that. And another compound is there, that is suppose halogen atoms are present to the adjacent carbon. Halogen atoms are attached to the adjacent carbon atoms, and these type of compounds, the common name of these compounds we will call vicinal dihalides. What we will call here? Vicinal dihalides. Very important this is. Vicinal dihalides. Or we can call weak dihalide. Weak dihalides. Or alkylene halides. Alkylene halides. Yeah? So these are about the nomenclature of haloalkanes or alkyl halides. Yeah? And then next we will discuss haloarenes, and after them we will go for the examples. Clear? So next one is IUPAC and common names of haloarenes. IUPAC and common names of which one here? Haloarenes. Clear? Halo haloarenes. IUPAC name and common name of haloarenes. For monohaloarenes, very important here, for monohaloarenes the common name and IUPAC names are same. The common name and IUPAC name for which one here? Monohaloarenes. For this one, IUPAC name and common name are same. IUPAC and common names are same. Suppose simple example. I will write here. This is the monohaloarene. This is chlorine. What we will call this is chlorobenzene. What we will call this is chlorobenzene. This is the, you know, common name and also IUPAC name. But for dihaloarenes, for dihaloarenes, the common name and IUPAC name are different. And so, what is the IUPAC name? Common name. First, I will write here, what is the common name? Clear? For dihalo compounds, common name we will start with either it is ortho or para or meta. Dihalobenzene. This is. If ortho or para or meta dihalobenzene is there, then it is a common name. If it is IUPAC name, what we will write? IUPAC name, what we will write here? Instead of ortho is there, 1,2 we will write. Meta if it is there, 1,3 or 1,4. Numbers if it is there, then it is a same dihalobenzene. Then it is, you know, if the compounds, this is IUPAC name. Simple example I will write. And suppose if I take, this is the chlorine. You know, these positions we will call as a ortho positions. And this position we will call as a meta position. Exactly opposite position we will call as a para. Now what I am talking about, dihalides we are talking about. See now. Suppose if I write this compound, chlorine and here chlorine. This is di. In this one, this is, you know, common name if I wanted to write. To this chlorine, this is ortho position. So that's why we have to write common name of this compound is, what we will write the common name? Ortho dichloro, dichlorobenzene, ortho dichlorobenzene. If you write IUPAC name for this compound, what we will write? This is one position, this is two position. We will write 1,2-dichlorobenzene. Same. If I write here meta and this is chlorine, this is which position? Meta position. So that's why common name is here. Common name is, you know, meta dihalobenzene. Meta dihalobenzene. But IUPAC name, if you write here, IUPAC name, how to write this is 1,2,3. So 1,3 dihalobenzene. In the same way, if you write here chlorine and chlorine, this is what common name? Common name is para dichlorobenzene. Para dichlorobenzene. If you write the IUPAC name of this compound, it is which one? 1,2,3,4. So 1,4 dichlorobenzene. So this is the IUPAC name of haloalkanes and haloarenes. In the next video, examples we will discuss.